नमस्कार आदाब सत श्री अकाल दोस्तों, स्वागत है आपका एक बार फिर से हमारे YouTube चैनल ब्रास फ्यूजन्स पर, जहां आज हम आपके लिए लेकर आए हैं एक नया लेसन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम,
आप सबको हिंदी दिवस की शुभकामनाएं।
सेम टू यू।
थैंक यू। तो आज हम शुरू कर रहे हैं नया पार्ट, दैट इज थियरीज ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट पर्सनैलिटी और थियरीज ऑफ लीगल पर्सनैलिटी, और वी कैन ऑल्सो से द लीगल पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ द कॉर्पोरेशन, है ना। Different terminologies can be used, and it's a theory because the concept is evolved, and then you know, lot of discussions happened, criticism happened, and then the theory was materialized. So you know, to begin with, I will share the screen. Anybody waiting to join the class, let me know, or else let me start, because in between again it will be difficult for me. So yes, I am not prepared fully, you know, the slides of the same. So let's begin with the concept of legal personality or the theory of so to begin with, it is based on, are you able to see the screen?
Yes ma'am.
Yes. So you see, this is the picture. So all these are the, you know, picture that I have been used from the Google, and all these are copyrighted you know, pictures, but I'm using it for the educational purpose, so I'm exempted for that purpose. I'm not circulating it, that's the reason. So this is what, you know, a person, you can see that he's sitting there in a chair with lot of old furnitures, and this is what, no, he's Salomon and Company Limited. So it's the old picture. When I searched, I come across to know this company images. Okay, so now this is the first case, or this is the, you know, theories which we are going to discuss. To begin with the case, we will let's have a, you know, and this is again, this slide also I have taken. What this slide signifies is that this is the company that has been formed. But before we go into the facts of Salomon versus Salomon and Company Limited and getting it analyzed and discussed, today we will just give the theoretical perspective of how this personality, or how this corporate personality, how we can treat a legal person as a, you know, real person. So that perspective only I'm going to discuss with you today, and not the case law. So what is important is that there is no doubt that we are all human beings and we are all legal persons. But the humanity is actually a kind of, you know, a state of a nature. Because since you are born as a human being, you are a natural legal person. So the law of the land, wherever you are born in, the law of the land of that place is going to rule you, and you are duty bound to follow the rules that has been made. So since we are all born in India, the Constitution of India is our document based on which we are ruled, or you know, all the legislations are part of that constitution only. So our, that's what the basic structure that has been enshrined in Keshavananda Bharati also gave, the you know, the constitution supremacy, or the constitution is the supreme, it is the law of the land. And based on that we have the numerous legislations, all the legislations are there, but always they have to go for the test of whether it is constitutional or unconstitutional. Based on that only they are, you know, recognized, or we say that that legislation, that provision is unconstitutional. We always use these terms. So so this is, this we are aware because we are all human beings. But what about those entities that has been created by artificial or by artificial means? So a legal personality signifies an artificial construction, and this is actually the discretion. This artificiality, dekho artificial robots hum bana rahe hain, hai na, abhi to ISRO ne to space mein jane ke liye kya hai uska naam jo hai Vishwamitra hai wo, anyone of you can just remind me, I just read that ISRO ne jo ek naya humanoid kiya hua hai na, Vishwamitra its name is, I forgot, I read it somewhere. Anyone of you remember that? Which is going to space mein jane wala hai, humanoid banaya hua hai, sorry ne. Anyone of you please?
Vyom Mitra.
Good. Thank you. Vyom Mitra. See, that has been created. Vyom Mitra has been created. Ab wo to natural person bhi nahi hai, lekin wo bhi space mein jayega. So, you know, like that, it's a creativity. So this artificial construction or this legal personality is, you know, legally constructed. So it's not your right. Remember that. It can be taken also. So it, the origin of this, you know, corporation is actually the logical extension or a separation of a humanity from legal personality as a group of humans who are engaged in a common activity. So kya hua? जब ये लीगल पर्सन जो है, जो नेचुरल पर्सन जो है, वो लोग जब अलग से एक ग्रुप बन के, वेन दे कम टूगेदर एंड वेन दे, वेन दोस ह्यूमंस बिकम ए ग्रुप, देन दे एंगेज इन ए कॉमन एक्टिविटी, देन देयर जॉइंट एक्टिविटी विल टर्म देम द स्टेटस ऑफ ए लीगल पर्सनैलिटी. आई होप दैट यू आर एबल टू फॉलो दैट. सो यू नो द फर्स्ट पर्सपेक्टिव in this regard we can see is that what they say is that the human being, so human beings you cannot separate, human beings are required, the existence of humans are required even for creation of this artificial entity, because the company cannot stand alone though they have separated or given a separate status. So what it means, it's only a giving a separate recognition or a separate status to a group of individuals or the persons who have come together for forming a association or forming certain kind of venture. So in this regard, you know, one of the theory is Jerrings. And see in the chat box, Jerrings, he says that a legal person is a real personality in an extra juridical or pre juridical sense of the word. I'm typing again the word, you know, I was not able to get the time to type all these things, though I think I will do so many things, but unfortunately I'm not getting that much of time. Juridical, extra juridical, pre-juridical. Okay, these terms. So Jerrings' theory says that who is a legal person? A legal person is a real personality. He is a real personality. A real personality in an extra juridical or pre-juridical sense of the word. And according to this theory of Jering, Jering is again a, you know, jurist, or we can say that a jurisprudence, his Jering has contributed. So according to him, this theory assumes that the subjects of rights need not be human beings. Okay, subjects means the people who are associated with the rights. That's why company also enjoys certain kind of rights, certain type of you know, fundamental. They are not excluded from all of the, you know, fundamental rights. Certain fundamental rights are provided even to the companies. So the theory assumes that the subjects of rights need not be human beings, that every being which possesses a will, a life of its own, may be the subject of rights and the state. So it does not mean that only those who are. So if you read the article which I shared you in the, you know, written by Professor Bakshi, you will find the discussions regarding these aspects, like whether the companies are also, or you know, they also should get the human rights, or whether they are, you know, when you are saying that companies are violating the human rights, that means companies also should have a kind of human rights, hai na? Jab aap kehte ho ki rights violate kiya, to fir wo dusra jo jisne violate kiya, unko bhi kuch duty or rights hona chahiye na? Or does it mean that only duties? Does it mean that only the corporations and companies have only duties, no rights? Jaise ki hum abhi bhi karte hai na, we always say that we are all aware about our rights. We all know that what we are entitled to. But what we need to contribute, we are silent. Jahan pe hume contribution ka time aata hai na, then we will just, ab dekho kahin bhi bhi koi show chal raha hai. Aur jaise hi paise lene ka waqt aa jata hai na, bahut sare log wahan se gayab ho jate hai, ya fir apna purse mein खोजने की कोशिश करते हैं कि कहां पे है, क्या है, एंड ऑल लाइक दैट. सो व्हाट डस इट मीन? सो दिस जेरिंग्स, यू नो, जेरिंग हैज कम अप, ही हैज कम अप विद दिस थियरी दैट अ लीगल पर्सन इज एक्चुअली अ रियल पर्सनालिटी, बट विद एन एक्स्ट्रा ज्यूरिडिकल और प्री ज्यूरिडिकल सेंस ऑफ द वर्ड. एंड सो द राइट्स दैट आर अवेलेबल आर ऑल्सो एंटाइटल्ड फॉर them, and they need not be, and it is not that all the rights are only available to the human beings, and then they are, you know, they have the eligibility. But a corporation or a company, they are also like a life, or they are also like the human beings, can should be treated as human beings. And then actually these corporations, they are the foundations. They are the foundations, and they are capable, because if a human being can have a will or can have a say, similarly a company also need to have a say. And he used the terminology, you know, the terminology of companies are social organisms. Dekho. Companies are treated as social organisms. And if we see that corporate personality, or we say that when the corporate social responsibility is provided, and when we are attaching them the social perspective or the social welfare measures, then that means they are also capable of enjoying certain type of rights. So social organisms. And the common will, that means here the will of these social organisms, or the what does it mean? It is the common will. So here the members of the corporation, or the will of the founder, will be different from the will of the corporation. So it's like, you know, it's really a tricky aspect, or we can say that's a tricky type of question. Like, how, when you are saying that's a social organism and it is having its own, you know, common will, when we are saying it's having a common will, and that will is different from the will of the members of the corporation or from the will of the founder, that means a company can have different voices. कई बार होता है ना, जो founder जो होता है company का, उनका objective होता है कि कैसे करना, you know, he will be having a different ideology. But afterwards, in a long run, the objectives of the company gets, you know, different from what they were thinking of it. So in that way, we can justify the Jerring's theory that the corporation's, you know, ideology or their will or their right will stand apart from the members of the corporation will. So that means all the members that who have subscribed to the memorandum of association, all of them have will have a say, and depending upon the most suited or which the company adopts, that becomes the company's will, and that differentiate it as a social organisms, right? And then the legal personality, that means the so-called the natural persons and the so-called juristic, when we are referring to it, both are equally real, because the law gives an existence, law recognizes it, and law gives it an recognition, and it is equally, what happens is that it is equally artificial and it is fictitious. It is artificial and fictitious, of course, because it only law provides or gives it an existence, and it is the co-found of the personality with the capacity. So if the law is not providing it with the support, or if the law is not recognizing it as a separate personality, then it will not have a say. Okay, so a kind of what we can say is that we cannot say that a company is having, of course, company is having a separate legal existence, and we cannot treat it as a human being, but we cannot say that a company does not enjoy the rights that are provided to the persons. But of course, it is not treated as a citizen. Of course, that case law we will be discussing. So what happens is that once the, you know, once it is recognized or once it is made, the entity of the enterprise becomes institutionalized. So it is actually the institutionalized, or it is getting institutionalized. It is pre-juridical. It is pre-juridical, not prejudicial, pre-juridical. Juridical means, judicial means what is provided in the law, but this is the recognition that is given by the, through the, you know, case laws or through the jurists and jurists, because we are discussing the theory of Jerring's. That's why I use the word of juridical, because the philosophy is also evolved, and all these are based on, you know, the case law which we are going to discuss the facts and all, that is the Salomon's case. So before we discuss, that's what I thought, that it's have a theory part very much clear. And there is one more aspect, is that what is the benefit that the company enjoys? What kind of benefits? Of course, we discussed about the you know, benefits, but what an entity or enterprise enjoys once it becomes institutionalized. It becomes institutionalized in this regard. The Palmer is again a person who has written a very good book on you know, company law. Palmer's on company law is a very authoritative book for the higher understanding of this concept. So what he says, that the benefits that is following from the incorporation, it can hardly be exaggerated, because at the moment that incorporation takes place, the owner of the business ceases to trade in his own person. You know, once you are incorporated, then you will cease, that you cannot say that it's my own. Okay, jab aap incorporate karoge to fir aapka aur होता है ना कि आपका और कंपनी का अलग हो गया. यू कैन नॉट से सो द इनकॉर्पोरेशन द ऑनर ऑफ द बिजनेस सीसेस टू ट्रेड इन हिज ओन पर्सन एंड द कंपनी कैरीज ऑन द बिजनेस. सो द कंपनी कैरीज ऑन द बिजनेस एंड द लायबिलिटीज आर द कंपनीज लायबिलिटी. The company's liability, the liability of the the company become its own liability. And what happens? The owner of the company is without any liability. He is without any liability because he is not personally liable. We have discussed, but the company will become liable. And once the company does, the principal shareholder, he is able to take full advantage of the profits which the company makes. And if लाइबिलिटी जो होती है कंपनी की तो वो कंपनी की लाइबिलिटी होती है. लेकिन जब कंपनी को कुछ प्रॉफिट मिलता है तो फिर दैट प्रॉफिट और द एडवांटेज दैट ही विल एंजॉय. सो दैट इज व्हाट यू नो द इनकॉर्पोरेशन सिग्निफाइज दैट इट मेक्स इट इंस्टीट्यूशनलाइज्ड और इट गिव्स द फीलिंग ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन. देन वंस इट इज इंस्टीट्यूशनलाइज्ड then there is a separation of a company and the founder or the owner who has made or who has incorporated that company. And that's what Jering says, it's having a separate existence and it's having a separate social responsibility and it need to be treated as a separate social organisms. Companies are actually the social organisms, and without the companies and without them, then it is very difficult for a country. Can you imagine a nation without the business people, without the companies? Can you imagine a situation where there are no companies at all? In any nations, not I'm talking about India alone, if you take any country or any nation, can we say that it does not have any company, it is not doing any business? So that means, business or, formation of the company, incorporation of the company, functioning of the company are all the essentials for the smooth life or for, continuing with the progress or the growth of the country. The lesser the companies are, and if we don't have the companies and we don't have it, then lesser the growth of the nation or the country will have. If we just see the once before the liberalization LPG, liberalization and privatization policies has been introduced in 2002. Prior to that, we have seen that we were having very limited companies which were transacting business in India. And we have also seen that time the progress of the country was also not that much advanced, because formation of the company, and there were monopolies that were there, they were huge giant companies, or they were monopolies were existence. And what they used to do, they used to dominate. Their products used to be in the market. You don't have any option. Were you able to get, suppose, say, for example, if we take initially the Nokia mobile phone, okay, in the if we just take, it was in the initial stages, Nokia was there. Then who else? Then I think what was the other brand which were there along with the Nokia? I think Ericsson. So we can see that they were, and pager, pehle to pager sab karke. So you have also seen in that field, you are having limited sources. आपके पास ऑप्शन नहीं है, इधर आप जो भी मोबाइल चाहिए यू कैन जस्ट यूज दैट. लेटर ऑन मेनी कंपनीज वर गिवन, नाउ यू हैव, आपको ये पसंद नहीं है तो फिर दूसरा देखो. यू हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ ऑप्शंस फ्रॉम वन टू अदर, विच वन ब्रांड टू अदर ब्रांड. एंड सिटिंग एट होम नाउअडेज यू कैन ट्रांसैक्ट, ई-कॉमर्स. सो ऑल दीस थिंग्स हैव डेवलप्ड एंड ऑल दीस थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ द कंपनीज अलोन, रिमेंबर दैट. So the policies that has been adopted encouraged, or the the soil became so fertile for the companies to explore their own businesses and their entities, and then that has resulted in the growth. And of course, unfortunately, now we are going to the another phase where these companies are facing problems because we all know that the COVID has changed the circle, not only of the companies but all of us. So like the human beings are also affected, the companies are also affected because of this scenario of COVID. Because people, those who, and if we say, if and now even if the human rights perspective also we see, a company can give you, because their income is depending or their profit is depending upon the sales that they are making, the profit that the company is making. But now, since some sectors, they can't make the profit, they are going on the loss. So the employees there, they are also, that's the reason that they are paid half pay. Many firms are paying half pay. And many of the people are, nowadays facing the jobless situation. So now if you blame the company for that, then how the, so they, and when we say that it is their duty that we were employed and they should protect us, of course, that's there. But for them also, from where they will get the profit? And it's not, I'm saying that the profit they should give as a dividend to their shareholders, but their own employees comes first. For them, the salary, paying of the salary and giving the perks that were given, if the company is not in a position to earn, then that becomes difficult. So, we can't blame or we can't say that the company is also not doing because of this type of situation which we are going through. So the gist of the discussion today is that the Jerings theory, which says that the, extrajuridical, or it is a legal person or it is a social organisms, stand still. Because whatever the things that is affecting a human being, jab hum sabko bimari aane ke, matlab health ke wise, we are all, thinking, then the companies are also is going through the same phase. And now when we are saying that, we need to follow the social distancing and then we should sanitize and come clean. Now for many of the companies also, now it's the time they should cleanse. They should come with the clean hands. Then, and how they have to clean? Unka jo bad debts hai, debts and all the, jab payment nahi karte the, jab unke haath mein paise the, and the way if they were doing the bad type of businesses, now it is the time to cleanse, use the sanitizing method and then come clean and then do some kind of good type of business, and then that will result in the growth of the economy and for their benefit as well. Because every time we cannot say that we don't have the money and we are not in a position to pay, and there's an employee who worked with you, who was very loyal for you for so much of time, for a time being you can make him half pay, but you cannot throw him away because he is again the asset. Because if he's there, only your company can again revive. So you also have to think. So because here the company should also use its brain. I'm saying that's the persons who are associated with it. So the Jerings theory of corporate personality still stands relevant because of he used the term of social organisms. Though a company is having a separate legal existence apart from its owners, it has to go through all the natural calamities or the problems that the natural or human being is suffering from or the human beings are going through. So that becomes the company's a real personality. It becomes a real personality because of that reason. And now coming to the case of Salomon versus Salomon and Company Limited, I will just give you the facts of that case in brief. Actually, this Salomon was a boot and shoe manufacturer. If you have seen the picture, I have shown you a person who was sitting there. So he was a boot and the shoe manufacturer. So his business was in sound condition. Always, he was as a sole trader, he was doing or he was flourishing in his business in a very high manner. And then he always have the surplus of assets. Always he used to make the huge profits than the liabilities. So what happened? He incorporated. He incorporated a company that is known as the Salomon and Company Limited. So he thought that since now I am enjoying as a sole trader and I am making a huge profit, why not I incorporate it as a company so that I will get a social status. So he converted his sole trader business into the company, that is the Salomon and Company Limited, and to take over or to carry on the business in, you know, in a wider manner. As we have already discussed the benefits of formation of a company, he thought of expanding it from the sole trader to the other avenues. So in that manner, he incorporated the incorporated business as a Salomon and Company Limited. And there is a requirement of subscribers to it. So the subscribers for the Salomon and Company Limited were, there were seven subscribers. Who were they? Out of the seven subscribers, Salomon himself was there, his wife was there, his son was there, his daughter was there, and his four sons. So four sons plus one daughter, five, plus his wife, six, and Salomon himself, seven. So total seven people, seven persons of his own became the subscribers for this Salomon and Company Limited. Then what happened? After that, the business was transferred. So the business, they have transferred it to the Salomon and Company. It was for, you know, $40,000. So it's not, you know, money and all that doesn't matter, but he has transferred his sole trading business, which he was earning, I told you, a surplus he used to earn, and then he transferred it to the company. And out of this, you know, he has taken 20,000 shares. So out of that 40,000 surplus fund that he has contributed or incorporation, usme se 20,000 shares was taken by Salomon. And apart from that, he also took the debenture. That means a kind of loan that the company takes. So a debenture worth 10,000. So 30,000 was in his own hands. And this debenture certificate that the company owned, the Salomon, he was, you know, he was given it as a secured creditor. Wo to secured creditor tha. Then unfortunately, what happened? After 1 year, the company went into liquidation. So देखो जब अच्छे से प्रॉस्पेरिटी थी उनकी, लेकिन क्या करें, किस्मत अच्छी नहीं रही, तो आफ्टर यू नो इनकॉर्पोरेशन फॉर वन ईयर द कंपनी वेंट इनटू लिक्विडेशन. सो व्हाट हैपेंड आफ्टर दैट, वाइंडिंग अप प्रोसीडिंग्स आ गया. वाइंडिंग अप के टाइम पर एसेट जो थी कंपनी की 6 थी, लायबिलिटी जो.
दोस्तों अगर आपको आज का लेसन पसंद आया हो तो वीडियो को लाइक करें. इसी के साथ अगर आपने अभी तक हमारा चैनल सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो सब्सक्राइब के बटन पर क्लिक करिए और बेल आइकन दबाना ना भूलें, ताकि आपको एजुकेशन से रिलेटेड नए नए अपडेट्स मिलते रहें. और अधिक जानकारी पाने के लिए आप हमारे फेसबुक और इंस्टाग्राम पेज से भी जुड़ सकते हैं, जिसका लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में दिया गया है. धन्यवाद.